After more than 10,000 earthquakes, 18 centimeters of ground deformation, and a widely felt magnitude 5.2 quake, a new volcanic eruption finally began on Iceland's highly populated Reykjanes Peninsula. This eruption began just north of a subglacial ridge referred to as Litli Hrútur, which translates to Little Ram. As magma had been pooling at under 500 meters depth in the last 24 hours, and the rate of intruding magma was measured at 88 cubic meters per second, it became clear that a more intense eruption was going to occur than witnessed in 2021 or 2022. Thus, after smoke started pouring out of the ground only to be followed by a series of 30-meter or 100-foot-high lava fountains, it was not all that unexpected. What, however, was unexpected was the fast rate the relevant fissure expanded at and the amount of lava it produced. Whereas Fagradsfjall's 2022 eruption involved a 400-meter-long fissure, the latest eruption expanded in only a few hours' time to 500, then 800, then 1100 meters in length. Now, two segments of a lengthy fissure, one which is almost 850 meters in length and the other of which is 250 meters long, are erupting lava along their entire lengths. This formed a fairly large field and then a river of molten rock which began flowing downslope. In only 4 hours' time, approximately 0.72 square kilometers were covered in lava, totaling approximately 2.16 million cubic meters of material. Based on this, it appears that an average of 60 cubic meters per second erupted during this period, which is 6 times higher than witnessed during the 2021 eruption. While large amounts of sulfur dioxide production and a high rate of lava effusion are ongoing, there is thankfully no indications that any buildings are at risk due to the lava flows. Instead, lava is flowing towards a lower elevation area to the south and then southeast of the active fissure. For context, in the first 2 weeks of Fagradsfjall's 2021 and 2022 eruptions, the highest rate of lava effusion occurred at the onset of the eruption. As time progressed, the eruptive rate waned, slowly decreasing over time with some exceptions until the eruption ended. What set the 2022 eruption apart from the 2021 one was the higher rate of magma input into the source vents and average higher eruptive rate. Thus, the duration of the 2021 eruption can be owed in part due to its slow lava output. Since the latest eruption is 6 times more intense than the 2021 eruption, I caution that, in my opinion, the eruption could be potentially even shorter than the 2022 eruption, although we are unsure what exactly will happen next. There simply isn't enough information yet to try and determine how long this new eruption will last for. However, since the last two eruptions of Fagradsfjall loosely followed the same pattern, it seems somewhat likely that the latest eruption will also follow this pattern. It appears that Fagradsfjall is still probably in the stage where additional fissures could develop with little or no warning, and we do not want someone to get hurt if molten rock suddenly is thrown into the air right next to where a person is standing. Whereas the first eruption took a month to noticeably decrease in intensity, the August 2022 eruption notably decreased in intensity on its second day. We might get some indications of how long the current eruption will last based on the increase or decrease in eruptive intensity, ground deformation, and nature of the eruption observed in the next week. For now, enjoy the spectacular show of lava through numerous live streams. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.